As a franchise, Tomb Raider has done just about anything a video game can do. But there's always room for another first. Through the years, Eidos has chosen one young lady to be Lara. For the first time ever, all past live-action Laras come together for a high-profile photo shoot. For Ian Livingston, creative director at Eidos, it's a family reunion of sorts.
I've been so pleased to be the real Lara's father, to see all my daughters back here in one room again, all giggling and reminiscing about their days with Lara Croft. It's fantastic, and they're all enjoying it, I'm pleased to say. I think I'm the only one who's really aged. They all look amazing.
Here's a year-by-year look at a decade of devastatingly dashing dames.
It has changed my life. Even now, actually, I still get lots of letters from people all over the world, which is just mind-blowing. I can't believe people still associate you with the character and just really still are big fans of the game itself. Having a child is amazing. What can I say? It's the best thing that I've ever done, and I think it really makes me realise what life's about. It kind of puts everything in perspective.
First time when I heard about Lara Croft was when my friends were playing this game day and night, and I was like, what are you playing? What are you obsessed about? I thought, oh, this is Lara Croft, you know, she's really hot, and actually you do look a bit like her, and you've got the same name. It was meant to be. When I went to character, I felt very strong, very confident, very sexy, very powerful, because, you know, Lara Croft is all that.
I was the youngest ever, so I was just turned 17. When you get into the outfit, you're a changed person. You're just in the role of Lara Croft, and you can do anything, and everyone looks at you like you've just stepped out of the video game. I think it's a feeling that I'll never have again. My best memory of being Lara Croft was my biggest fan, who was from Amsterdam, and I think he bought my wisdom teeth on the internet. I think that made his day, really made his year. I think when I became Lara, I didn't know who I was as a person. And travelling with a group of people around the world, especially being 17 and new, it kind of made me who I am today. So it meant a lot to me, and I'll always remember it.
I definitely felt like character transformation because it was really stepping into Lara's skin. I was really out there and ready to kick some ass. I was extremely tall with my boots, and it was just really intimidating. People would really be, you know, like astonished. And I love to make people smile. I love to entertain. So it was great fun. It's just really nice that you can see that some fantasies do become reality.
Do they ever? The photo shoot was a resounding success.
One, three, one, two, three. I did one more, that was pretty hard.
Much like the game, the Lara model has evolved too. In 2006, the latest Lara, Karima Adabib, tackled unprecedented training with the British military. From army combat to zipline tactics, Karima's role as Lara was the toughest yet. Can she live up to the top-notch standards set by Eidos? Time will tell.
When I first got the job, I was told there were previous Laras before me, and I remember getting home and getting on the internet immediately, trying to do my research on these girls. I've taken a lot from what they've already done, because they're my predecessors. To better myself, I take the best qualities and try and put it into one.